All right, so let's say you have a WordPress website running Elementor and you want to change it into Divi. How would you go about it? So in this video, I'm going to be sharing step-by-step how I converted my website from Elementor to Divi step-by-step and share pretty much everything that I did to get my website to work the way that it is now. But before I get started, I'd like to remind you that if you buy Divi using my affiliate link, I will give you access to my web design formula course, a course that teaches you how to design professional looking websites with Divi. All you have to do is to buy it using my link below and then send me an email. All the information is down there in the video description and I'll give you access to that course. Okay, so you may be thinking, well, Mac, why would you use Elementor? You've always been a Divi guy and pretty much all your tutorials are based on Divi and not one of them is based on Elementor. Now, it sounds like a hypocrisy or a contradiction for me to be promoting Divi and yet I use another page builder. So I'll just tell you what happened there. So a few years ago when I created my online business, there were things that I couldn't do in terms of integrations, especially LearnDash. I mean, LearnDash could not integrate very well with Divi at the time. And I was finding it very hard to really connect the two and have my website running the way it was supposed to. So I ran Elementor for a while. I tried to use Divi as a plugin. That didn't work very well as well. But when Divi updated their system and introduced the theme builder, that was a game changer. That was the moment where basically I could use Elementor, Tutor LMS, any of these softwares that I normally use for my online business. It would make it easier for me now to use that. But I did not change right away. So the main reason why I did not switch from Elementor to Divi straight away after Divi 4.0 was because I was afraid that if I start tinkering with it, I might break things. And also when the theme builder came out, I had quite a lot to learn in order for this to work. But deep down, I knew for a fact that Divi had a better UI, and that's my opinion, by the way. Divi has a better UI and it works much, much better. So you may be thinking now, well, why change? Because Elementor pretty much does the same thing as Divi does. Well, there are several reasons. First of all, I'm very comfortable with Divi. And because I'm part of the Elegant Themes team, I pretty much know, you know, how to use all these products because I make tutorials every single day. And this is the most important one. There's an update that is going to come out very soon, which is going to improve the speed of Divi. And this is going to be a game changer. Our websites are going to be super fast. So me deciding to switch my website from Elementor to Divi was a very, very good move. So what I'm going to do now is to show you how I did the switch from Elementor to Divi and how you can also switch if you really need to switch. But please bear in mind that this is my own personal preference. Of course, this is not a video about which is better, Elementor or Divi, whatever it is. Everyone has their own opinion. This is just me showing you how I did it. And if you wanted to do the same thing, this is what you would do. So first of all, let's switch over here to my site. So as you can see here, Divi is my main theme. So it's active and it's running. So the very first thing I did was to make sure my blog post had a decent layout. So I did not want to use the normal layout that you get when you install Divi because it's pretty basic. So what I did is I went straight into the theme builder because that is how you need to start designing your site. Go to the theme builder and create a template for all the pages that you need. So let me show you how I did that. So over here, if I scroll down to Divi, you want to go to the theme builder. So the first thing I did was I created a template for all my posts. So you can see here, I have all my posts. In fact, you know what? Let's go in and let me show you what this looks like. Okay, so this is a basic layout. You can see here, I have my main area here, which has my title, and this is dynamic text. So this is what it would look like. The title here is dynamically created. So it just shows up here and the date as well. So this, if I go in here, you'll notice that this is a post or archive title. And as I mentioned, it's dynamic. The same applies here to the date. So if I come over here, as you can see here, this is also dynamic. Now over here on the bottom, this is what I did. So I went in and I changed the titles of my text in here. And I also changed my paragraph text. And then over here, I just gave my images some rounded corners here. And then going further down here, I have this promotion for a special bonus when you buy Divi using my affiliate link. Now, this is quite special because you see, if I come over here and I scroll down, you're going to notice that it is not showing over here. So you may be wondering why. Well, the reason why it's not showing is because I wanted to make sure that this is only shown to people that are interested in Divi only. So when they come to my blog post, they will see that. And if they're interested in it, they'll buy. But if someone has already bought Divi, they will not be able to see this because it is tag based. Okay, so let me show you what I did here to make sure that this is shown to the right people. So if I switch back here, over here on advanced, if you click on visibility, now this is very important. If you click here on visibility, I have Fluent CRM installed on my website, so I'm able to choose tags to show content on my page. So over here, you can see it says interested in Divi and anyone that has this WordPress mastery tag. So this is very important because I don't want to show this message to pretty much everyone on my site, those that have bought Divi using my link. So I want that to be hidden from them. So all I'm going to get here is anyone who is interested in Divi, okay? So that's how this is shown. And that is how you can create your content on your pages. Now let's move on to the next part. And that is showing you how I created my footer. So if I come over here to my page here and I scroll down, you can see this is the footer that I have. And again, this footer here was done in the theme builder. So this is how you want to create your website fast and pretty much have everything up and running really quick. I was able to get the site up and running, I'd say within about 2 hours. So it is really cool to use the theme builder. Okay, so over here to create my footer, and you can see here, this is global. I just came over here and I chose my colors. In fact, in a moment, I'm going to show you how I created my colors and how I chose my colors for my website, because that is also a very important step. All right, so over here, you can see this is my footer. I added a background color here and also added all my links. Some of these links are very important, and because they link to my business tools, the resources, and also important blog posts. And here as well, I thought I'd add this site was built using the Divi theme builder, and highly recommend it. So this takes people to my landing page where I talk more about the Divi page builder. Okay, so that was the footer. And the beauty of creating your website this way is once you create your footer globally, it's applied across the whole website. So as you can see, this is very, very, very powerful. So what also I did here was after I created my footer, I also went into the global body. And this is where I went in and customized the text that I need on my site, the colors, the size, and so forth. So you can see here, this is the color, the paragraph text, the font, everything is all selected. So every time I create a page on my site, is going to pretty much adopt this text and also the colors and the layout. So this is very, very important when you design your website or you move your website from Elementor to Divi. Make sure you work with templates. It's going to speed up your workflow and make things easier for you. Now imagine this, if you wanted to go in and create all these pages from scratch, one by one, it's going to be very, very difficult. So doing it this way is much, much, much easier. Okay, so let me show you something else that I did here. So looking here at my theme builder, and I'm sure you can see now that I'm spending so much time here in the theme builder. This is what pretty much brings structure to your website. All right, so here I also created my archive pages. I also created a template for all my pages. And then here I have specific ones. So this is all like landing pages. So you may need a landing page which does not have a header and footer. So I created a specific template for that. So every time I create a page that does not need a header and footer, I can just assign this template to that page. So let me show you how I'll do that. So I have my template here. So let's say there's a page that I need to target for this. I can just click on this gear icon and then I go to specific pages. And as you can see here, I have this Buy Divi theme. I also have the Buddy Boss landing page. So these pages are quite different. Okay, so you can see here, this is the Buy Divi theme. So it's a landing page which does not need to have a header and footer. So that is how it is following that template. So these are the bonuses when you buy Divi using my affiliate link. Of course, I'll give you access to the web design formula course, the Photoshop for web designers, and you also get the WordPress mastery for free. So you can see where I'm going with this. I have specific templates for specific type of pages. Okay, so let's move on and let me show you what I did next. So over here, I have my color palette. So these are the colors that I use on my site. So what I had to do here was to go into my Divi options. So it's important that you go to your Divi options and add your colors here. So here, this is my color palette. So I will just come over here, copy my color like that. And then I'll just come back, go in, paste my color like that. And pretty much this is how I populated all this. So every time I design my site, I know exactly what colors I need to use throughout my sites, because this color palette will follow me everywhere I go in the theme builder. So this is why it's important that you use a color palette before you start designing your website. So once I had my templates all created, I added my color palettes. All I had to do now was to just make sure that all my links are linking to the right pages and I have no broken links. So you may have situations where some of the links that you have in your site are not working correctly, or they are broken, or some of the content is not showing correctly. This is where you want to go in and make sure that those pages are working okay. So in my case, it doesn't surprise me that I may find pages which have a short code and content is not showing correctly. This is mainly because maybe that page needs to be taken care of on its own. So in a nutshell, this is how I converted my website from Elementor to Divi. And like I said in the beginning, that's just my preference. This is not a this versus this type video. That's the process that I used to convert my site from Elementor to Divi. So anyway, guys, have you done this process before? Maybe there may be a few things that I may have missed. So please do share them in the video description below. Until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.